Hi everyone, this is Veronica. Today our topic of discussion is about trolling in India. So what does this trolling mean? Who are the trolls? So we'll discuss that in detail. For my video updates and queries, you can connect with me on Instagram and Facebook, because I feel together we can make a difference. So talking about the relevance of this topic for your examination, it will be covered in your mains paper 3, social media networks and internal security. At examination level, you should know about the abuse of women on social media and its implication, and then who is basically accountable for this online abuse. Now, what is the current affair here? In what context today we are starting this? Because Troll Petrol India exposing online abuse faced by women politicians in India, it is the name of the report that is released by the Amnesty International India. Basically, trolls are the people who like to upset people online. They use such language, they try to provoke the other people, they are known as troll. And what they do is known as trolling online. So this report has basically analyzed more than 114,000 tweets which were sent to 95 women politicians in the 3 months during and after last year's general elections in India. On the basis of this, analyzing these tweets, some lakh tweets, the report has been out now. So here you can see the softer targets. So it is said that women are usually the softer targets of such people. So women politicians from India, what they say, has faced significantly more abusive and problematic tweets compared with their counterparts, counter-colleagues, same women politicians in UK or US. And even the women who are by religion Muslim politicians in particularly, they have faced more such tweets than other. You can just see here, we'll see more data. So this is Indian female politicians, they have it rough. So this color is for problematic tweets and this is for the abusive content. So you can compare here between for the women politicians in India and UK and US, you can see the difference. And then even the problematic abusive tweets, proportion of tweet mentions, proportions of abuse also. So this is for the top 10 most mentioned politicians. That means the people who are so famous, so they receive it more. And here we'll talk about the highlights of this report now. So this research found that women are targeted with abuse online, not just for their opinions, but also for various identities. So the abuse is based on your identity, on women's identity. Then these identities being, for example, like on base of their gender, on base of their religion, on base of their caste, and even on the base of their marital status, whether the person is married or unmarried. So Indian women politicians face substantially higher abuse on Twitter than their counterparts in US or UK. So around 13.8% of the tweets in the study were either problematic or abusive. So this problematic content was defined as tweets that contain very hurtful words or hostile content, especially if repeated to an individual on multiple occasions. But they do not necessarily meet the threshold of abuse. So while all women are targeted, Muslim women politicians face 55% more abuse than the others. And while all women are targeted, so women from marginalized caste, unmarried women, and those from non-ruling parties faced a disproportionate share of the abuse. So here you can again see types of abuse. So these are the categories. So on these bases, people are abusing women. It could be sexism or misogyny, ethnic or religious slurs, racism, physical threats, caste slurs, homophobia and transphobia, and sexual threats. So we will now change this variable, these categories, by keeping them same. We try to see what else women faced. So on the base of religion, so Hindu, Muslim, other, unknown, we discovered that Muslim women are having it more on the base of sexism, and you can see the different percentage, the data we collected. Again, we'll change this variable, this category will remain same. So this is on the basis of marginalized caste, general, who are facing what. And then again, we are changing the variable here to the political parties, for example, BJP or Indian Congress, Indian National Congress. So female politicians from BJP versus other parties. So that is why on the basis of this data, they have given the reports, highlights of the reports we discussed. So this is obviously a matter of concern because abusive tweets had content that actually promote violence against or threaten people based on their race, national origin, sexual orientation, gender, religious affiliation, age, disability, etc., etc. So they include death threats as well as the rape threats. So problematic tweets contained very hurtful and hostile content, often repeated, which could reinforce very negative or harmful stereotypes, although they did not meet the threshold of the abuse. So such things are known as trolls. So now here I would like to tell you about two online studies that showed a clear correlation between people who enjoyed trolling. So these trolls, they enjoyed because they don't have anything to do else. So now they have seen a correlation between the people who enjoy these trolling. So that has direct connection with their kind of personality they have. Dark tetrad of their personality traits such as sadism, psychopathy, right? So even if you'll see the people who do such kind of trolling online, either they are using a fake profile or they actually don't have anything else to do, or they're themselves sad, though, so then they enjoy trolling other people, provoking other people. One of the most well-known victim is Anushka Sharma. You have seen Priyanka Chopra. So all the people who are famous. So online trolling in July 2018, let me tell you about a case of Priyanka Chaturvedi, the 38-year-old national spokesperson of Congress. She was threatened with the rape of her 10-year-old child by a Twitter handle user. So Chaturvedi addressed that the trolling began after a fake quote of her on a recent gang rape of a 7-year-old supporting the accused circulated over social media. So this trolling started because of a fake news, and fake news is another problem nowadays. And then after the intervention of Union Home Minister, the arrest of Girish Maheshwar under sections of POSCO and IT Act took place. So this is not just about other people. This same thing happened with Sushma Swaraj also. She was India's Minister of External Affairs at that time. And what happened at that time? Basically, Sushma Swaraj issued interfaith couple with a passport. And then the trolling start. And when Swaraj put out a poll on Twitter asking whether such kind of trolling was deemed acceptable, then 43% of people on her profile, they said, yes, they're accepting this kind of trolling. This is okay. So I must say, such trolls, they're intolerant, rude, coarse, vulgar, and violent. So their weapons are basically hate speech and the fake news. They may not kill, but I suspect that many of them, if he or she was a part of violent mob in the real world, would not hesitate to do so. So now there's some other term, cyberbullies. Although there is a difference between trolls and cyberbullies, but we should not tolerate any of these. So trolls are basically, they tend to be more focused on online communities and groups. Their end goal is to bring attention to themselves. But cyberbullies, on other hand, isolate the victim and try to bring them distress. So their aim is to embarrass and intimidate a single person. They go about in this various ways, from leaking private pictures and videos to sending them to threatening and such kind of text also. So mentioned, now I will talk about what are the steps which are taken by the social media platforms to ensure the safety. And obviously Facebook, Instagram, the social media handle, they have taken out like comment filtering, or you can disable the comment. Even on YouTube you can do that. Microsoft has created web form where users can report hateful comments. Then there is another option called report abuse, right? So many such things have been introduced thereon. So what is the best way to deal with such things? So while India is still a long way from providing legal measures to safeguard against online trolling, there are some three rules that you can use in your behavior to stop such kind of trolls. One is silence is golden, because ignore such people. In reality, trolls are merely cowards who seek to validate their existence over the internet. The best response is no response. So let them stew in their own negativity. Next is laugh them away. So like the Abhishek Bachchan, if you have seen his tweets, he usually do. They understand the troller's success depends on how agitated they can make you, how much provoking they can do. So a well thought and funny response shows them you are undeterred by useless rants such as theirs. And then obviously kindness wins. So here I'm not trying to preach here. this really works. The nicer and calmer you are, the most confused they get. So let's kill it with kindness. So this is, you know, it can be used in your ethics paper if it is asked. But yes, obviously we have legal options also. Legal options against the problems like violation of privacy if it is cyber bullying, right? So we have some provisions here. Like, for example, publishing sexual offensive material on the internet, sexual harassment, defamation, criminal intimidation by anonymous communication, or insulting the modesty of a woman, or stalking. Then we have certain provisions here. So I will just discuss them quickly. For example, you have section 507 of IPC, that is criminal intimidation by an anonymous communication. So whoever commits the offense of criminal intimidation by anonymous communication, or having taken precaution to conceal the name or abode of the person from whom the threat comes, it shall be punished with imprisonment, either description for a term which may extend to 2 years in addition to the punishment provided for the offense by the last preceding section. And same goes in the other sections also. For example, in defamation, or somebody is insulting the modesty of women, or section 66E of Information Technology Act. So somewhere the punishment, fine, or both can take place. So yes, you have legal means also for such things. But definitely here we should try not to troll people. This is not a good thing. And neither you should get trolled, because harassment starts from your mind. So as I told you, firstly, definitely we can try about these behavioral changes in our behavior. We should not get affected by such people. But again, if it is something more than that, then obviously we have some legal provisions too. So this is all about today's lecture. If you have any queries, you can connect with me on social media, or for the PDF of this lecture, you can connect with me on Telegram, that is t.me/Veronica_Om, or you can just search Veronica Study IQ for the PDF. Thank you. So this is the channel Study IQ. If you're preparing for UPSC or any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are available. If you're preparing for UPSC CSE 2020, our pen drive course is available, where you can find 100% coverage of UPSC vast syllabus. Daily current affair updates will be available. Self-paced learning process is provided. This course has been prepared by top faculties of StudyIQ, and now you can purchase this course at ₹625 per month only. For additional information, you can visit our site, and there are the phone numbers also given. You can call them and gain the additional information. You can connect with me for my video updates on Instagram and Facebook, because I feel together we can make a huge difference. For queries, you can even email me. Thank you so much.